Good morning. Welcome to St. James Catholic Church. A very special welcome to our guests who have joined us for Mass. We are honored by your presence and participation. Please stand and let us join together in singing our opening hymn, number 422, Jesus Christ is Risen Today, number 422.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Happy Easter, everyone. We come on this beautiful Easter morning to celebrate the resurrection. The tomb is now empty, and we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. In order to do so, my brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins.
I confess to Almighty,
God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers.
Pray for me, Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who on this day through your only begotten Son have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Thank you.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give praise to the Lord. His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. This is the day the right hand has done mighty deeds. His right hand is exalted. I shall not die, I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. This is the day the The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, a marvel in our eyes. This is the day the
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloth there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloth and the cloth that covered his head, not with the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning, everyone. I add my own best wishes for a blessed, happy Easter along with Father Shane. Most of Holy Week, there's been a little question that's been stirring in my mind. Why? For those of us who have been lifelong Catholics, for that rather large group that joined us last night at the great vigil of Easter, for some who come only on occasion for, I assume, a variety of reasons, that little question. Why? Why are you here? Why did you show up? Let's face it. If we were in another part of the world, traveling east, and we were caught showing up this morning, we might risk having our throats slit. So, why are you here? Why did you show up? Well, I want to believe, I don't only think it's a part of it, but I want to believe that part of the answer is found in us. The Lord has blessed us in many ways as a family of faith at St. James, two awesome priests. Should I say that again? Dedicated deacons. We have a marvelous parish school with excellent teachers, very friendly community. I had friends last night who came from Louisville to be with us, and they told me after Mass that, goodness gracious, every person that kind of looked at us said hello. That's marvelous. And many are with us this morning. We have great children being shaped and formed into disciples of Christ. And if you ask any of them, because we've talked about it so much, if you ask any of them, what does a disciple do? They're going to tell you three things. A disciple prays, a disciple studies, and a disciple serves. That's all great. But I think maybe the most important thing, and quite simply, is what our children are learning is simply the difference between right and wrong in a world that needs that desperately. But the great thing for me is that I know they are going to teach their children the same. We have men and women who take in the homeless every Wednesday night, and they have found a piece of paper and a pen to write to me and to some who work in that, serve in that ministry, to say thank you, and that what they experienced was those folks treated me, I suspect, as Christ would have treated me. We have folks in our St. Vincent de Paul that feed the hungry and clothe the naked every week. There's a grandmother with her grandchild, her granddaughter, who come every Tuesday morning to this church and take care of all of the candles and all kinds of other different chores every Tuesday. It's a teenager. She was here at the 8 o'clock Mass, who frequently will bend over the book of prayers in the narthex and write down the name of a friend who's in trouble. Sometimes it's been an illness, sometimes it's been a bad decision. And then she'll ask me, will you pray for him? For her too. This morning there's an army of ministers who are going to take Holy Communion to the sick and the old. All that's the work of the Lord. All that is great. And I hope that's a part of why you are here and why you showed up. But let's not fall under an illusion. If we do, then the devil and the death will have won. And the word that the church gives us really throughout the entire Easter season, but in particular on Easter Sunday morning, is the word victory. The death, the devil, no more power over us. Since day one, as we have heard, those called by Christ have too frequently been the barrier, the stumbling block, and I at times stand in that line as well. It was not an enemy of Jesus who betrayed him, but one of his best friends. His name was Judas. It was not a loser who stood around that fire and said three times, I don't even know the man. That was St. Peter. Even our own St. James, along with his brother John, tried to sneak around the others to gain favoritism, with the Lord at the dismay of the other 10 apostles and the anger of many of the disciples. So if we're honest and don't fall under an illusion, that side of Judas and Peter and James and John are always present in us. Always, at times, in my dark moments, present in me. Why? Why did you show up? During the next 50 days, we started this morning, during the next 50 days of the Easter season, we're going to listen to the Acts of the Apostles. St. Luke, along with others, will detail what was happening in the earliest days of the church, in the infant Christian community. We're going to learn why they showed up. Listen closely over the next 50 days, because you and I are in the chapters of that book of the New Testament. And the Easter season's going to end on the great day of Pentecost, when we're going to hear, according to St. Luke, that that was the very first time St. Peter proclaimed the gospel. And what we're going to hear is that on that day, because of what they heard, 5,000 joined the church. Why? Why did they show up? They showed up because they heard the truth. The truth that never, ever, ever changes. From the very beginning of the covenant established between Adam and Eve in the book of Genesis, through Moses, through Abraham, through St. Peter, through St. John, through St. James, through the Blessed Mother, Joanna, and the other women who had the courage to stand at the foot of the cross and not walk away, they showed up and they stayed. Why? It was not because St. Peter and the other apostles were attractive. It was because they were attracted to Jesus Christ. They learned. As they tried to figure it out, that he was risen, he was alive, he is here. So why? Why are you here? Why did you show up? The rest of the answer is from Good Friday. And I began to think, to meditate, and to pray a little more deeply on Father Shane's brilliant homily on Good Friday. Two words. The Passion according to St. John. I thirst. Shared with us all the things that we thirst for, especially when we take on the behavior of Judas, James, John. I thirst. But this morning, the thirst is different. This morning, now, God thirsts for you and has found you, called you, commanded you, come, follow me. And the cry from the cross is more than just, I love you. It means I have found you. You and you and you and you. There's not much more that we need to say this morning than thank you. Why? Why did you show up? Because he is risen, and he is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And for that, we say amen, alleluia.
My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, the baptized here present, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God? Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us the forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Sorry, we didn't have a seat for you all, but it's pretty good. And we have been set free. Let us therefore approach the Father with praise and thanksgiving.
That Pope Francis, all bishops, priests, and deacons will be renewed in their mission of leading all people to Jesus, the risen Lord. Let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may manifest in concrete ways the truth of Christ's triumph over death during the Jubilee Year of Mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and confirmed will find in the church the meaning and happiness for which their heart longs. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, suffering, and alone, that they will feel the loving protection of our risen Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those we serve abroad, especially our brothers and sisters of St. Mark's Parish in Haiti, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to terrorism throughout the whole world, may all people find hope in the resurrection of the risen Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, let us now pause and remember your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. And for the intention of this Mass for Tom Barzee, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, you have already granted us more than we can ask for in the resurrection of Christ. As you answer our prayers, make us ever more faithful to him who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exalt him with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also from those who have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, and Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let's give each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
Number 443, Alleluia, Alleluia, give thanks. Number 443.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Once again, on behalf of our pastor, Father Martin, we're honored that you are here with us. To any guests that we have, any family members of parishioners, anyone that hasn't been here in a while, know that you are always welcome to celebrate Mass with us here at St. James. The door is always open for you, and we hope to have this big of a crowd on Sunday, because it's still Easter. So please make every effort to be here. But a special blessing to you and to your families. Enjoy the beautiful day. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go forth. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Processional hymn is number 853, Alleluia, Sing to Jesus, number 853.